But up now, we're not talking about Southeast Asia Majors.
No.
We're talking about Manila Cup.
We're talking about Manila Cup, and there have been, it's been quite the event so far. I mean, we're on day two, and yesterday there were so many great matches, so many breakout performances.
Strider Ben
Going up against Eita with the long con. Beats him in winners.
The classic.
They get the, yeah, the new classic. Gets to run it back in losers. And then
last
game, last round, pulls it out for the win. Gets his revenge on Strider Ben. I believe that was the plan all along.
That's the saltiest of the saltiest loss.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It doesn't get worse than that. And so coming up right now, we're going to have one of the favorites to win today here at
Mr. EG,
Manila Cup.
Justin Wong. That's where right. He won. Look at his shiny trophy. You won Marvel earlier.
Yes. It was, I believe, him and K-Brad?
Yeah, K-Brad got second.
Yeah. Pretty good. I like it.
So the players that are out, you know who are out?
I have a... Okay. Well, let's first start with myself. Let's start with myself. I'm out. And then
you lost to M-Lizard.
Yes, who peaced out Haitani.
He helped. He helped to the cause.
Yeah. So I didn't feel too bad about that. But yeah, who else is out?
Itazan. DNG's Itazan.
Who did he lose to?
Eita and some other dude in winners. Oh, Jiewa. He lost to Jiewa and then he lost to Eita. So he's done.
Ouch.
Very, very sad. Lost to two Kens. And now here we are. Justin Wong and Jiewa. This is... The Americans are doing really well in this tournament. Everyone is still in winners. The EG boys are going strong. You seem to be like kind of...
Yes, all the Americans are doing well except for one. Good news is I'm more of a world citizen now, Kevin. Thank you very much. I'll have you know.
Why didn't Mike join? Why didn't Mike enter?
Why did Mike Ross not enter the Capcom Pro Tour?
He would have just won it hands down, right?
I believe it's because if Mike were to enter, he would win. Therefore, it would be some sort of conflict of interest with his relationships. I mean, being with Twitch.
You'll call it collusions? You'll be Mike...
Yes.
Mike Lusions?
Correct.
Ross Lusions?
But really, Mike is the real winner, right? Because he went undefeated.
He is the best.
Yeah, well, I mean, if nobody beat him, he's still the best, right?
Yeah. I mean, technically, Lupe is the best.
Yes.
He beat the legend.
He did.
There's no one else. And then he just dropped the mic and left.
Hey, man. Sometimes, you know, you go out on top. I mean, that's...
That's the only way to go.
Yeah. Better to burn out than to fade away.
See, these two players are kind of like deep in thought. Jiewa has been traveling a lot.
Yeah, I heard he was... Where was he? He was just like in Australia or just...
He's everywhere.
Yeah.
He's got this new sponsor, Panda TV. They're flying him everywhere.
Huh.
But I'm pretty sure he's not too happy with his results so far. Last year he was pretty good in points.
Why not?
Yeah, he's got probably like 32 or 64 points only. Out of the many, many, many majors he's been to. So he's definitely not...
What do you think he needs to do differently?
Play more, I guess.
Play more.
Yeah. That's the only thing he can do different.
I don't know. I don't know. I feel like there's a limit at which you reach a point of diminishing returns from playing a lot. Like, playing is very important. You know, so that you gain the experience. But what's also important is studying. This is like the homework, you know, working on the matchups, watching the videos, your videos, the opponent's videos, replays.
Sometimes you might need to play another game to be better.
Oh, yeah. That's,
I heard Marvel players are better now. Because they played Marvel and they moved over to here.
Street Fighter V is definitely the Marvel of the series.
Like, maybe, like, you know, following the footsteps of Mr. Ray, the double R.
Huh. Yeah, I can definitely see how this is what makes good old Gutex a one-dimensional player, right? Is that I don't really do any of that. But I can see, there was like a little, a brief moment in time where I would play Street Fighter 4 a lot and then Third Strike a little bit. And I felt like what I learned in 4 actually did kind of help me quite a bit in Third Strike, even though it would have been much better to have it be the other way around.
I think 4 really hurt me in 5. This not. I feel like I'm still waiting for my character to come in 5.
You and me both, Kevin. But later this month.
That's for you. But I don't have anything yet.
Okay. So
tell me about your Urien, or Urien.
I don't want to get my hopes up. I mean, a lot of people are saying that he sucks, but Ricky actually, the other day, was telling me that Urien has actually got all the tools, and they may have saved the best for last.
Sure. I don't know. I haven't played it, so I don't know.
You don't even play 5, Kevin.
I play 5. I can not bother
you. I know what you mean, though. I know what you mean, because when, you know, the only character that I really have fun with on the current roster, that I mean really have fun with, is Mika, you know? And it's like every time I take a tough loss with Ryu, I'm just like, what am I doing? This is dumb. I should just play the character that I have the most fun with. But the problem with that, Kevin, is that if you're – then I'm led into the same problems and traps of where I was at in 4 and in Third Strike. Because if you want to win, you need to play – I mean, I guess you don't need to, but, I mean, it helps to play, one of the strongest characters.
I agree.
Playing a fun character will get you to a certain point.
I'm not having
– You're just not having fun.
I'm having fun playing Geef, but it just doesn't – I'm not having the maximum fun yet. Like, I really need a character that I can stick.
Have you tried Alex?
Yeah, no. Not working out for me. I'm literally playing Ryu.
You played Mika?
Yes. I don't like any of the characters yet. I'm waiting. Maybe next year, the next new 6.
Do you think it's only going to be 6 next year?
I don't know. I hope it's like 12.
Even at the rate that they've been releasing characters, I feel like it's tough.
All right. I think you're ready to go. It will be EG Justin Wong from the United States of America versus Panda TV's Jiawa from China. Top 16 winner side action. Karen versus Ken. Who do you think? Justin Wong free. What do you think?
Round 1.
It's a good question. Yeah, I mean, Justin is definitely the smart money in this matchup. And I think it's going to come down to how Jiwa can or not deal. Hey, how he can either deal or not deal with Karen's standing medium kick.
He's been doing really well. Great reactions with the uppercut. Oh, but look at Justin's footsies. That's a new button. I've never seen the anti-air before. Did he find that out?
I mean, in theory, it works. The problem is that you have to do it much earlier, I guess, and it's only good from like a certain angle. I think some of our other anti-airs are a bit more consistent. So we'll see we'll see if that's an anti-air that Justin uses consistently against this character, or if that was just like a one-shot deal.
Yep.
Either way, Justin Wong, he's got a little bit of a life deficit, but this could be the difference right here.
Oh, he just needs, he needs to build out the critical art, and then after that, oh no, he's done.
Oh, that's round 1 right there.
Yep.
All right. So, you can still,
Round 2.
This is the download. This is the download.
You can still buy out of your bet, Kevin.
You need the download round. I believe in Justin. The Wong factor will prevail.
Justin is clearly the favorite to win this.
He tried that anti-air again, but it didn't work out because of Tatsu.
Typically, Justin is a very patient player, and I want to see more patience and more turtling on his end, because I feel like that's where he really shines.
That's not use the critical art. Yeah, I think he definitely...
Nice. Oh, no. Execution error? Must have been. Oh,
he's
there
been dropping a lot there it today. Is. Even at Marvel, he dropped a lot of combos earlier.
Okay, so now Ju is going to start the third round.
Show the crowd.
Oh, very funny.
This is a hype crowd.
Very funny. Philip, the Manila likes to get hype. They don't get hype, they stay hype, Kevin. So Kenna's got a lot of meter to work with. Karen building up that V-trigger bar. Walking Jiwa into the corner. Jiwa's got to be thinking, hopefully he's not thinking about all of the other performances that he's had recently.
Well, he just finished organizing Chengdu Fei. So
what is that?
It's the ranking tournament in China, in Chengdu.
Ah.
So I just came from there. He was the organizer.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, so you're alright.
The most backhanded of compliments I've ever heard.
The blow-ups.
It was aight. Wow, this is the position where Justin shines, I would say. Large life lead, grinding the clock, sitting back, doing nothing, waiting for Jiwa to make a mistake.
The resident sleeper.
Yeah. I like the use of view reversal right there.
Oh, Justin's got his meter. He's almost done. I'm just going to do this standing medium kick. And Jiwa without the V-trigger is going to be so much trouble, like trying to come back. Oh, here comes Justin.
Well, that's it.
Watch it. Show the crowd!
We don't have anybody out there. This dude is Ron asleep at the wheel. Oh my god, the voices in our head, guys. If only you could hear them. Oh wow.
I'm done. I might need to leave this commentary after.
Oh my gosh, you're going to get kicked out of the booth.
I might fear for my life here if I leave the
Ooh.
All right.
Brutal.
Justin up 1-0.
That's right. These guys are playing 2 out of 3 games. First to 2 wins. This is winner's bracket, which means that the loser is not eliminated. They have one more chance down in the loser's bracket.
It's a race to 2, right? Yep.
Round yes. 1.
Probably race to 3.
Fight.
Now on the Ring of Destiny. Revealed the week Evo weekend. What a cool stage. Surprised to not see a run right there. Okay, now Justin's got his back to the wall right here. It's still... Oh, wow, what a...
Side switch.
Yeah, nice side switch right there. Jiwa's got a large... Okay, yeah, gets the stun. That's going to be round 1, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Okay, so again, very strong start by Jiwa, just like we saw last game.
Round 2.
Let's see Justin if he's able to make the adjustments. I think...
Standing medium kick. All your problems.
Yeah, that's what Jiwa is doing, right? He's trying to bait out the standing medium kick while he jumps. He tries to jump in and try to get in that way. Like at this distance with the Itatsu, but Justin is really good at adjusting his spacing to make sure that his Itatsu doesn't cross up.
Yeah. Plus, if you let Justin control the pace of the match, as he's doing right here. He's just going to basically play as slow and lame as possible, and then you constantly have to keep your gray life damage. Like, you got to pay attention to it so that way he doesn't get any big conversions off of like a tiny hit. But this is definitely where Justin really shines right there, just controlling the pace. I mean, now he's got V-trigger. Jiwa's in the corner. I mean, it's really not... Jiwa's going to need a small miracle right here, but of course, Justin, very patient.
Same story as before.
Yeah.
The last game. Justin lets Jiwa think that he's got the round, all the game.
Yeah.
And then he comes back with the Justin Wong.
But now he's got his back to the wall, up against the ropes right here. We'll see if Jiwa can make anything happen. Wow, that was a big damage throw right there.
Justin hasn't been sticking out his medium kick too much, though.
Wow!
Oh, no. Ran right into that one.
That confirmed.
We'll see if Jiwa can capitalize on having the life lead and having him cornered. Ooh! Oh. Caught him hitting a button on wake up.
But good tech by Justin. Oh, empty jump low. 1-1.
Man.
That was a good.
That was a runaway round right there.
Yeah, that was good response from Jiwa.
Yeah. Caught him with that crouch medium kick into super at just the right distance. Justin walked straight into that one.
Ricky and K-Bra having a talk about what happened, rooting on for their teammate.
But Justin doesn't look like he's too phased, going back to the game plan. Oh no, lets him out of the corner. He's got to be... Gotta be wondering how he let him slip out that way.
Nice autocorrect uppercut from Jiwa.
Both of these players pretty evenly matched right here. Justin being a little bit more conservative with the way that he's using his V-trigger now. Karen gets a lot of, like that move right there. Karen only gets that when V-trigger's active.
Nice chase back there.
Yeah, both of these guys with V-trigger active now, very dangerous. This could go either way right here, but it looks like Karen's got the advantage because she does.
That reaction from Justin. Recognizes the run, reacts with a throw.
Super hard. Super hard to react to right there. Justin has got the reactions of
of Eita or Fudo or Xiaohai. Definitely on point. Justin wants to make this count. Wants to make his first Asian debut with a win. Currently one of the top ranked players in the CPT.
Yeah, Justin's got just shy of a billion points right now.
Justin's gonna activate right now. Put Jiwa in a lot of pressure.
Yeah, I mean, even though it didn't kill, it was still a smart use of the resources right there. Now all he's got to do is kind of grind the clock and not get hit by any of Ken's V-trigger shenanigans.
Jiwa is fully stopped right now.
Yeah, he's so dangerous. Oh, here it is. What? What?
Justin with those reactions.
You can't. It's that.
Really? Justin Wong.
Justin looked at me. I was surprised, but Justin looked at me and was like, yep.
I knew it.
I would like any of the stream monsters that got training mode open right now. Recreate that situation for me. That was Ken's V skill, V trigger active, and then use Karen's crouching light punch to hit a button afterwards and see if that actually works, because I don't think it does.
It doesn't?
But maybe it does. I think step kick V trigger makes you even on block. So since Ken doesn't have a three frame normal, Karen sticks out a three frame normal and then gets the counter hit, I believe.
All right, up next is Team Kill, Ricky and K-Brad. But first, I would like to apologize to the Stream Smith for trying to direct him. I feel really bad. I was too hyped, I was caught in the moment, and I got reprimanded. And I am eternally sorry.
Wait, everybody in the chat is saying that it's +7. So if it's +7, how can he hit a button right there?
+7 is a lot.
That's a lot, guys.
Are you sure?
Are you guys sure? Because he hit a button. Did I imagine the whole thing? Did this not really happen?
Did Jiwa try to do a fierce then? +7 is like a lot, dude.
Justin got the count. He activated, and Justin got the counter hit.
Yeah. No, it can't be +7. +7 is too crazy. Well, I guess it's +7. We'll find out. We'll go to... All right, everyone says it's +7, even the Japanese dudes.
Right, okay.
Wait.
Look at it.
Wait. Okay, I want to know. It's Justin and then Jiwa. And then next in the bracket is K-Brad and Ricky. And then the winner of that moves on to face Justin.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes. No floating here. Everyone just... Straight train to Busan.
Straight what?
Never mind, it's an Asian joke.
I'm sure it was very funny.
But up next.
Anyways.
The fantastic.
Anyways, yeah, sorry, Lewis, for being backseat streamsmiths.
They even chose the same color scheme. K Brad with Cammy versus EG Ricky Ortiz with Chun Li.
Alright. Definitely two of the strongest players. No stranger to fighting each other. Ooh. K Brad is. Actually, both of them have just such great neutral game. I'm getting private messages now that it's plus +7. Right. Okay, so it doesn't work. It's just that Jiwa. There was a there must have been an execution error on Jiwa's part. Alright, so K-Brad's got a nice life lead. But Ricky activates B trigger. Still got her back not anymore. Doesn't have her back to the wall anymore. Let's see what K-Brad. Oh my god, K-Brad fights his way out of the corner. Wow! Ricky having none
nice
of this stuff!
Wow!
Woo! That.
That was exciting.
It's quite the finish right there.
And this is the kind of Street Fighter I love to see, the American style Street Fighter.
American style.
The rush down, no host bars, keeping the hype, none of that footsies, walk left and right spacing stuff.
Get that stuff out of here. Oh, no.
Oh, nice combos and rush down from Ricky. Oh, nice cross overhead.
Nice conversion right there. Ricky takes that second round pretty convincingly. K-Brad's had to have been thinking at the beginning of that second round, how the hell did this happen?
I didn't make the bracket, so it's not me.
No, I meant after in the first round. The end of the first round, I think K-Brad thought he had it.
Okay.
But I'm saying he was still thinking about it as the second round started. And that cost him.
Oh, the entire didn't work out for Ricky. Nice reads from Ricky, but was not able to hit Cammy off the air.
Ooh, nice. On reaction? Oh my gosh. Every time K-Brad tries to get some momentum started, Ricky has got the answer.
You see that sick whiff punish? The standing fierce Cammy whiff punish?
K-Brad's reactions are so good. Ooh. Could be it for Ricky, but she's got. Yep, that's it. Okay. Yep.
That's a very nice round from K-Brad. Adjusting really well. Feels like K-Brad is getting way more confidence in this round.
Yeah. Well, I think he's over what happened in that first game. Ricky's got a very nice life lead right here. Ooh, on the verge of stun. K-Brad's got to do something to get. Oh no, that's it. It's going to be a match point for Ricky. K-Brad, one round away from getting sent to losers. He's got to be feeling pretty stressed right now.
No, K-Brad isn't stressed. He's K-Brad.
That's true.
Stone Cold Stunner.
He definitely didn't look stressed, that's for sure.
VIP room blow up.
All right, so K-Brad's got his back to the wall right here. Almost fights his way out of the corner.
Almost did another whip punish with the heavy punch.
Yeah, it's really hard to do. Oh, no. Did you see it? K-Brad tried to uppercut through that fireball.
Yeah.
I got hit by that yesterday. I was like, it was so sick I wasn't even mad. It's like that scene in Anchorman where he comes back and he's like not even mad at the dog. Oh, I'm not even mad. All right.
Drops the tennis strike.
And Ricky is just doing a great job of suffocating K-Brad.
Oh no.
Nice conversion. EX spinning bird kick? No.
K-Brad with no fear going in on Ricky.
Ooh, that was wild. Wow. We gonna see a chip kill into super? No, not necessary. That was weird. The view reversal worked, but she didn't end up on the other side.
Yeah, I think her V reversal on block is like -7 or -8.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna check that.
Because I was kind of practicing how to punish it, and it's.
I'm going to bust open Frame Assistant Tool, which if you guys are wondering, you know, if you guys always wondered if Cammy's V-Reversal was -7 on block or not, then
let's
check out a cross-platform iOS and Android frame data tool. V-Reversal, -8 on block. Wow. How do I keep letting Cammy get away with that?
See? Learn something every day. Yes. Watch the Capcom Pro Tour.
Yes, that's right. And you know, we are coming down to the end of this season's Capcom Pro Tour. And what a year it's been. You know, this is the first year of Street Fighter V.
6,000 at EVO?
That is a lot of people.
Yep. Up next on your right side is Cola321.
Ooh, the guy who beat...
Haitani?
The guy who put Haitani in losers. Mm-hmm. And on the left, Red Bull Bonchan.
Who beat Cola's countryman, Zowie's Gamer Bee. To
wait.
Make it to the top 16.
Oh, yeah. Gamer Bee's with
Zowie
here now. Yeah, Zowie. Yeah.
Doing really well.
Hell yeah.
But of course, we want to give a shout out to our sponsor, monitor sponsor of the Manila Cup,
yes.
ViewSonic, providing us these wonderful 27-inch monitors. Cien has just recently tested them. If you go to the Beast APAC YouTube site, we have did a lag test video.
Really?
Yeah.
Tell me about your method.
He just used one hand and he just goes on there and plays. And it used the human
that's not
emotion and feel.
Oh, Jesus. That's what I thought.
Yeah. We don't have those fancy equipment that, what's his name? Adil has. He has the...
Forward.
He has the fancy equipment. We don't have that.
I think it's just like it's like one piece of hardware. It's like $70 or something. It's not even that.
Sure.
We're just gonna.
I was thinking we could buy a 10,000 frame camera and then record the frames and then press like punch at the same
right,
time.
Right. Yeah, no, apparently it's not. All right, so these guys didn't want to play on the most beautiful stage in the game.
I love that stage. They should just.
Kanzuki Estate Beach? Come on.
Koreans.
Yeah, that's the Philippines. That's like.
The official stage.
The Boracay Beach stage.
Unfortunately, banned. Maybe they can fix it.
It's not banned.
It's banned on the CPT.
Really?
Yeah.
They banned their own stage?
Why did it? It had to be done.
It didn't have to be done.
You couldn't see footsies. You couldn't see the footsies.
Nah.
Round one.
All right, but instead, you're going to get this nighttime juggle stage. The nice eclipse moon there in the background. Too many stars to count. Bonchan has been doing really well these days.
That's right, and Cola 321 taking him to Suplex City.
Cola 321, formerly known as Xiaohu.
Xiaohu?
Yep.
What does that mean?
Little Tiger.
Little Tiger.
But now he has changed his name to Cola.
I like Little Tiger a lot better.
He likes the Cola. He likes Coca-Cola.
No.
I don't
really?
Know. I'll find out.
You should ask him.
He was drinking a mocha, though. So.
Round two.
Oh, these guys.
Oh, nice. Anti-air there from Bonchan. Empty jump low.
So working on a really good life lead and a perfect...
Do you see
every
single button in footsies? It's so clean for Bonchan.
Yeah, I mean, Nash has a lot of tools. Arguably the most tools out of anybody. But Vega's no slouch as well. I mean, he has two different stances, claw on and claw off, which make the punch buttons do different. You know, they have different animations,
yep.
different moves.
It's It's better for footsie's game, footsie game without the claw. His buttons
are
faster.
Right, so the claw, but the problem with the claw is that it falls off if you take too many hits.
Yep. Wow, dash up! Grab.
Boneshawn on the verge of tying it up, one round apiece. But Cola 3-2-1 not going down without a fight.
Pressing way too many buttons, looking for that jump check OS. Round. Fight. Wow, just a random startup slide.
But it worked. Was it crazy or genius?
I will.
Hard to tell.
Categorize it as crazy. Nice pokes there from Cola. Seems like Boncha has been neutral jumping a lot.
Ooh, not taking none of this off the wall stuff.
Oh, here comes the super.
Wow. That is a counter hit only combo right there.
Woo. Nice clean match here from Boncha.
So fancy.
You can see how much he has improved. He hasn't been doing well. He says that he's taking his time to learn the game. And he's getting better.
Each
Pro Tour event, ranking event, you see him getting better and better. Fight.
Yeah, I mean, there's so much to this game. The meta. I don't see a lot of other Nash players doing these counter hit specific combos off of crouching light punch. Wow, there it is again. Woo. Oh. Caught him hitting buttons. Cola 3-2-1 in the corner. Gotta rethink his life right now. He's got some time to think. Oh no.
Gotta get out.
He keeps on doing that string, and it's not working out for him.
Yeah.
But he's got a chance here.
Oh, nice walk up to avoid the teleport.
What a momentum shift right here by Cola 3-2-1. Totally stole that round. Boneshawn taking a drink of that Red Bull, trying to rethink his life right now.
I like the shirt that he has on. He has the white version and the black version. But, Cola definitely must feel good about that round.
Yeah, but Boneshawn, I don't think, was too fazed by it because he just went back to, it's just business as usual. I mean, and that's really the sign of a really strong player, is to be able to regroup mentally after getting a round, arguably getting a round stolen from you.
He just needs to do what he did before. And He doesn't need to change much in his game plan.
Boneshawn working on a good life lead right here.
Oh, nice jump in. No anti-air from Cola. Match point.
One of Vega's weaknesses is that it can be difficult for him to anti-air without, you know, one of the traditional reversals like an uppercut or a flash kick.
Boneshawn fully stocked, looking to close out, but Cola.
Got the dizzy, about to tie it up, one game apiece.
Not over yet.
Not over, yes, that's right, Nash.
Nobody.
Taking him to Suplex City. Ooh, let's go. Oh my God! Ends it with the heel to the forehead.
Boneshawn definitely, like when he got up and did that grab, there was no reason for him to do that. He got nervous.
Well, yeah. I mean, it happens, Kevin. You know, you're fighting for your life out here with these CPT points. I mean, you know, stress levels are high.
Oh, nice anti-air there from Red Bull's Boneshawn.
Oh, nice reaction right there. Not falling for the command grab setup right there. Nice conversion. Got Nash stuck in the corner, and he's got no V-trigger until... Oh, still has no V-trigger to escape.
Oh.
Wow, that's the end of round one. Boneshawn now on the verge of being sent to loser's bracket. Cola 3-2-1 got to be feeling pretty good right now.
He needs to regroup fast for Boneshawn.
I mean, he does have almost full super, so he's going to have a lot of resources to work with in a moment, but he just spent one on EX Sonic Boom. I don't know if that's going to come back to bite him.
I think he's fine for now. He just needs to get himself together and close out this round first. One round at a time.
Okay, so Cole has made a couple of adjustments with his game.
A good
didn't go for
reversal.
Didn't go for the target combo right there. Oh, no. This could be it.
Oh,
wow. What great defense by Bonchan. Oh, no. Drops the combo again. Still has his super, though. Can he recover?
Can he
stay alive? Wow, what a scramble that was.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, man. That is a heartbreaker. Wow, what a finish right there. Both of these guys were scrambling to hold it together, and Bonchan had the opportunity when he popped his V-trigger. He ended up on the same side like he wanted. He even got connected with the medium kick coming down, but then wasn't able to convert into the full combo.
There was so many chances.
Super. Yeah, I think he got too excited. You know, sometimes you get that stray hit and you're like, oh yes, I got it. But then you drop your combo. Oh my gosh, that is a heartbreaker right there.
It's all right. What Bonchan needs to do now is go back and think about it, sit down and relax. He still has the loser bracket. It's not out yet. And
still in it.
Yeah. And Bonchan has been in this position many, many times before. He's able to compose himself. But up next will be... Oh, who's this dude? New dude. Kazunoko versus PBE Don. Playbook Esports Don.
Yeah, so Don, widely considered to be one of the strongest players here in the Philippines.
Used to be Drew.
Fight.
From Imperium. And now it's Don is one of the strongest as well coming up.
Yeah, so Don plays Ryu. We saw him in action yesterday. They put him up on stream first to open the show. And I gotta say, he's definitely got a very impressive Ryu. Gotta give credit where credit is due. I saw he has a kind of a unique rushdown style, but at the same time, he's also really good at knowing when to hold back and kind of let the mental pressure build on his opponent.
He's playing against Mr. Kazunoko. I don't think mental pressure is going to affect him that much.
Kazunoko seems impervious to basically everything.
He just do what he wants to do. He's Kazunoko.
Yes.
Like,
but that sort of mentality is what allows him maybe to get away with so much of what he does.
Yeah. He didn't do that well in last week's championships in China.
Uh-huh.
But he's still in the hunt for points. He really needs to win this.
That's right. The 2015 Capcom Cup Ultra Street Fighter 4 champion.
Yep. Like Xian has 500 points and he says he's not safe.
That is a lot of friggin' points.
He says he's not safe.
Not safe. 500 points. Need more. Well, then where is he?
He booked his flight incorrectly, and now he's in Japan.
Cameraman, I gotta say.
Hey, he's graduated. I don't deal his flight stuff anymore. He does it himself.
I don't think that's a graduation. That's more of a demotion.
Oh. Dr. Jimmy hyping up the crowd here. Why did he only hype out the left side of the crowd? What about the right? Like, I see a lot of Filipinos on the right.
I don't know.
And Filipinas.
I don't know. We got to get, you know, clearly we need to have some of the sponsors volunteer some talent support to, you know, do the equivalent of holding up the round one cards, round two cards.
We're doing that in Southeast Asia Major.
Oh, good.
We have cosplayers to go up and do the
excellent. Excellent. That's what I like to hear. Always raising the bar, Kevin.
I learned it from you.
Thank you. I try.
Nice footsie here. Oh, dash up throw. No uppercuts from Don.
Very really hard to react to.
Here comes Kazunoko.
Nice combo right there. Don't see that one too often. Now the tides have turned. Don on the verge of stun. He's got to do something. Ooh!
Wow.
Oh, that's dirty.
Air.
Put that one into the memory bank right there.
I think Don could have uppercutted there because he blocked the on-way. On the jump in.
I'm not sure. Yeah. We'll see if Kazunoko does it again. Kazunoko, quite the reversal of fortune right there. Don was doing a really great job of controlling the pace of that first round. Oh no, made him crack.
I think this is it for Don here.
On the verge of stun right here. Kazunoko's doing a really good job of keeping his stun meter active.
Yep.
For those of you guys that are new to the game, keep an eye on the meter right below the life bar. That's the stun gauge. The more hits that you take, the higher it builds. But even if you don't take hits, it's still, even if you're blocking hits, that it still doesn't let your stun bar go down. So it can be a pretty good a tactic to build somebody's stun up and then keep attacking safely and force them to make a mistake.
And as well as if your opponent thinks that you're trying to keep his stun gauge active, he might do a random DP.
Absolutely, yeah. It's a mind game in and of itself.
Ooh. Very nice round there.
Curious as to what button Don hit after that sweep.
Don thinking about life right now. Like, how did everything go wrong? I started out well. The crowd was hype. Everyone's chanting some other dude's name.
Yeah, what happened here, guys?
Alright. The Filipino crowd getting behind their boy, PBE Don. But Kazunoko, God's Garden Pro Kazunoko, having none of that, wants to shut Don down as soon as possible.
Oh, no conversion right there after the light attacks. Oh no, quite the conversion right there. Kazunoko had built up his gray life quite a little bit and then got that jump in.
I like to see Don use standing medium kick more. Oh, and here's a good huge damage.
Doesn't activate V-trigger. Lets him get away. Man, I think that's going to come back to bite him. I don't know if I agree that was a smart move not to activate.
Oh, nice defense here.
Okay, you get the crush counter, you had the V-trigger, you
max
didn't
damage.
Activate.
Yeah. And you couldn't bring it to the next round.
Yeah. There was nice. I don't agree that it was a good idea to not activate. And now, hopefully he's not still dwelling on it like I am. But I think that he is.
Oh, nice uppercut. I think Don definitely feeling the tournament nerves in a big stage like this. You can tell that he's not making the right decisions that brought him here. He's been doing too much stuff that it just doesn't look like he's ready. And that's it. Kazunoko closes it up. Moves on.
Damn. The pride of the Philippines sent down the loser's bracket for not activating V-trigger. I mean, who knows what would have happened? I think he's going to be that moment right there, that scenario is going to keep him up at night. Many sleepless nights from now until Manila Cup 2017, thinking about that one.
He still has loser bracket. What are you talking about?
What?
That was winners. He still
I know. Okay. I know. All right. Just because he's not out doesn't mean he's not going to be thinking about it.
All right. I'd like to thank all our sponsors, Imperium, for organizing this tournament. And of course, if you want to check out the brackets, be sure to go to manilacup.challenge.com. These wonderful guys at challenge.com just recently got bought over by XSplit. A wonderful
XSplit building that media conglomeracy.
Yes, and hiring all the American streamers all to Philippines.
There has definitely been an exodus of StreamSmith talent from America to the Philippines. Holy smokes. Guys, there is
Mondo is here. Farpanudo. Offcast, Spooky.
Round one.
They're planning to hire more.
That is a hive mind of that is a StreamSmith hive mind mastermind group if I've ever heard one. Holy smokes!
Yeah. And of course, shout outs to Red Bull for all the drinks they have provided at the venue.
That's right. Thanks, Red Bull.
And also shout outs to ViewSonic for helping us with all the monitors.
Hella monitors here. Sien tested. And Kevin approved. The most scientific of methods. It felt great. What are you talking about?
Hey, come on. Xian is the most technical player, one of the most technical player in the world. Plays multiple games, tested it with all the games.
Yep. Stamp of approval.
Stamp of approval.
I'm sold.
Not good enough?
You know what? I only got to play on him this week, so maybe if USonic sends me some, then I can do my own scientific test.
I was supposed to introduce you to them. They want to do something with Cross Counter.
Oh.
And an affiliate program.
Right up my alley.
I showed them the PogChamp thing, and they were like...
The PogChamp thing?
The PogChamp video. When you used to do the joystick clue.
All the skits.
Alright, up now, it's PAD's Lim Filtration, Mr. Ron Lim, from Philippines versus Oil King from Taiwan. Shi Yowang. This is Chinese team.
I love that this dude named Oil King plays Rashid. But he's not even Middle Eastern.
I know. It's
he's
so
from
funny.
Taiwan? That's wait, he's from Taiwan?
Yeah, he's from Taiwan.
Oh my god! The King of Oil! God, somebody stop this man!
Habibi, please! Oh, but Lymphiltration making a comeback here. Oh, wow. EX Spinning Mixer.
Woo!
Wow,
oh my
nice
gosh,
respect.
What a match we have already here at Manila Cup.
Oh my god! He's got a tank! One more, overhead.
This could be it for Oil King. Lymphiltration! Oh! Lymphiltration trying to tell him about renewable energy. We got solar! We got wind power! We got hydro!
How about nuclear?
Now there's a technology that has definitely, I don't know if it's been taken to the limit. But I'll tell you what, if Oil King doesn't rethink his energy strategy.
Fossil fuel.
Yeah, yeah. Can't rely on fossil fuel forever, says Lymphiltration. Let me show you how we bullfighters do it in España.
Oh, wait. Making the comeback here.
Oh my gosh. That's the second EX tornado. Oh my god. Straight through. Wow.
Oh, he knows. Adapted.
My gosh. Vega rolling through those tornadoes.
But I think Oil King is definitely hedging his bets and putting into wind power.
Yes.
So many tornadoes and whirlwinds. Whoa.
The crowd going nuts with the Olay chant.
This is loser's bracket, actually, so.
One of these guys is going home. Lymphiltration.
We sucker now.
Got the crowd hype. Woo, my gosh.
Hawking's got to stop jumping in like a scrub. Great dash.
Let him know how you really feel, Kevin.
Oh, yes.
I gotta say, the Oil King buys his way out of trouble. Totally shifted the momentum. Now he's got Lymphiltration in the corner with no bar. Okay, now he's got V-Trigger. Not the place you want to be.
Nice defense
here
from Lymphiltration. Oh.
Got Lymphiltration on tilt.
And
I gotta say, the power of the wind from the other corner. Blue Lymphiltration away. Yes, you're welcome. Ooh, Oil King on a roll right now.
I feel like I'm casting with James Chan right now.
Yes. Not safe right there by Lymphiltration, excuse me.
The ultimate mix up. Wait.
Oh no, doesn't put himself in the corner. That was very strange. Stun right here.
Oh,
this is going to be game for Oil King. Oh man, says, hey, we got fossil fuels. We got renewable energy. My energy is renewed. Crack the knuckles, back in it.
I think Lymphiltration definitely was like feeling himself too much in that game. And he just went ham. And
yes.
He lost.
Vega is a character of finesse. Woo! Not taking none of your stuff, Oil King.
That was sick.
Oh my gosh, look at that gray life right there. Gosh, that was a lot. Oh, wasn't able to convert. Put that one in the memory banks. I've been very impressed with the Vega players out here. Oh, nice conversion. Infiltration on the verge of being stunned right here. Overhead, no! Gets his way out! B-trigger, B-reversal, nothing! Oh god, do something! Infiltration, you're gonna get stunned! Nope. All right. Oil King with a moment of restraint right there. I like it.
I like to see more neutral jump from Lipotrician. Wow, what a nice mix up there.
Oh, so God, sick. That was so weird. I haven't seen that one before. Oil King, quite the innovator.
Wow, just wake up buttons here. And match point for
Oil King. The crowd has gone very silent here. We went from Olays to golf claps. Ooh.
Nice pressure here from Oil King. Random slides from Lipotrician. I don't like to see that. It looks like he's just trying to make something happen instead of having a good solid game plan.
Yes. Cameraman with the real talk right there.
Ooh. Good jump, triangle jump.
Oh, this could be it for Infiltration. Where are your Olay chants now?
Oh, here comes
God, I can't believe he hit a button right there. Full super. No. He dropped it. No. Oh, my gosh. The Philippines has blown the opportunity.
I think oh, come on. Random jump.
That's it. He had it. He blew it. God. Infiltration. With the execution error, the missed opportunity,
the brain
possibly
fart
of the tournament, the brain fart of the year. After you hit that two-button B trigger, all it takes is two quarter circle forwards and hit a punch button to convert that into a super. They would still be fighting right now, cameraman, were it not for that brain fart.
I am speechless, but up now. It's Gamer B. Zowie's Gamer B. It happens, man. It happens.
That's you guys. You seen the face palm where it's just like
the one that goes through
yeah,
the
hit. Through your face.
Infiltration. Lots of heartbreaks for the Filipinos. First started with Don against
You know, they actually one of them asked me like, what separates us from the Justin Wongs of the world? What do we need to do in order to beat guys like Justin?
Play more.
It's not as simple as play more, Kevin. You got to do more than just play more. There's plenty of people at home that have been playing online for
play
weeks,
months.
Go
to more tournaments. And, of course,
travel.
There's this book on Amazon that you can use.
That's right. If you
know that book, it's not. It doesn't start with the D.
No, what does it start
There's
with?
There's no DDR here. I actually don't know what's the first letter of that book. But I know it starts with a G. The real G wrote it.
That's right. We got books on Amazon Kindle. You don't need a Kindle to read it. So many people are like, I don't have a Kindle, Gutex. I can't read your book. I'm like, Jesus H. Christ.
Is there's that a his Kindle real middle name?
There's a Kindle app for every platform. You need to educate yourselves and read more so that you would know that you don't need a Kindle device to read Kindle to read Kindle books.
Oh, Bully tries to pull a fast one and pick the
I liked it.
Da beach.
I like it.
Da beach. How was the beach? Have you been?
Which beach? Which beach, Kevin? Because when I hear the beach,
I'm so triggered.
I'm so triggered, Kevin. This beach. My palm is bleeding right now. I'm so triggered.
Harambe in the house. All right, Zowie's Gamer B, Nakali in Losers.
Okay, there we go. Now there's a respectable stage.
No beaches here.
Ring of Destiny.
Oh, good jump in there from PvE Bully, Playbooks Esports Bully. Making his first debut on top 16 at the Capcom Pro Tour. And this is what Gamer B loves to do. Good spacing, extend that standing medium kick, and then bait the jump in, and then uppercut.
The Gamer B special got PvE Bully cornered. Oh my gosh, Gamer B has got a little bit of gray life that he's got to worry about. Nice conversion by Bully.
Woo. Oh, try once. Was looking for something.
I've seen a lot of Filipino birdie players do that. They get the knockdown and then immediately go for the EX chain. It didn't work on me, and it didn't work on Gamer B.
They're reading something here.
Bad reads all around.
Should be reading Blue Texas book on Amazon.
Yes, exactly. Read more books, guys. It doesn't have to be mine. Just read enough so that you know that there's a Kindle app for every platform. Please read more books.
Round two.
Nice dash up throw here from Gamer B. Looks like he wants to close this out real fast. Smells fear in
smells, yeah, oh yeah. Can smell it from here. Oh, this dude. Oh, I played this guy.
Is he good?
Yeah.
He's in top 16. He has to be good.
This guy beat my ass, dude. This guy's really good, dude. I think he's the only Filipino player that I lost to in a set.
Wow.
Oh, that's not true. That's not true. That's not true.
Big punish
there
here.
There was a Chun-Li player that was really good as well.
Drew?
Might have been. I'm not sure. This guy was good.
B-Russels.
Anyways. All right. Another uppercut right there by Gamer B.
You can't jump in like that predictably against a world-class, one of the best players in the world for Street Fighter.
Yep.
Like that. You can't do that. Just disrespecting Gamer B. Like these jump ins, he's just too jumpy right now.
Yeah, I mean, Bernie's got such a slow jump. You really gotta pick your battles, and you probably don't want to do it against a character with such a strong uppercut as Nicali.
Yeah. And he's doing way too many predictable moves and stuff, too. I would actually suggest that he backs off and then at least try a few can setups and stuff.
At least try to litter.
Yeah.
Can one of the only moves in the game that's like plus 11 or plus 19 or something ridiculous like that. It's got a lot of frame advantage. But it's useless, as are all moves, if you don't ever try to utilize them. And Bully just looking, oh, maybe not. No, yep. Looking a little bit outclassed here by Gamer B. Ouch. Got him, got us back to the ropes. Reversal of fortune right here. Maybe not.
Gamer B just knows when to wake up DP, and it worked for him like so many times.
That's experience.
And match point for Gamer B now. Bully looking really just outmatched here by Gamer B. Not close at all. Good start here. Let's see what Bully can do.
Wow, Gamer B says, no you don't.
These wake up uppercuts are so legit, right?
Yep. He's batting 1,000 on those today, folks. Gamer B coming for those CPT Manila points.
Oh, another one of these setups.
Ooh! Ooh!
So sick! Oh, I didn't hit.
That was fast.
And Bully's on. You can tell on Bully's face, like, he totally did not have an answer. He didn't know what he was doing.
It looked like he may have admitted defeat before the fight even started.
What would you tell him? What would the book say? Give us a sample of the passage that has been written by Mr. Gutierrez.
To be honest, like, I mean, the game is, the book is for, like, new players. So I felt it was important to focus on stuff to get people up to a level of competency before talking about any sort of, like, intermediate slash advanced stuff.
Maybe
but
you can
thinking about it now, a preview of the next book.
Yeah, book two.
What would I tell Bully?
What would you call it? Would it be Super or it'll be Ultra?
Super Fighting Game Fundamentals? That's funny. Ultra Fighting Game Fundamentals. That's funny. That's a good one. I'm going to remember that one. Or, you know, that's what I'm going to call the second edition. Because I'm working on the second edition. Yeah. I got Fighting Game Fundamentals Super Edition.
And then the third one will be Third Strike.
Yes. Fighting Game Fundamentals Second Impact. Anyways, I guess the takeaway from that for Bully would be to watch the replay. Because tell me if you experience this, but lots of times I've had multiple people ask me how to watch the replay when you're fighting locally.
Yeah. And I don't know this, so if you can tell me, that'll be fantastic.
Okay. So when I lose, if I lose or have a close match in tournament, at the end, when it's over.
No handshakes. This is Korean versus Korean. Burnout
no
from
love.
XSplit, the sponsor of this tournament.
No love lost. Fuck
good,
that.
Shows good sportsmanship. Reaches out to M Lizard for a handshake, and he's like, nah.
So.
Okay, sorry.
Alright, so at the end, the menu goes as follows: play again, character That's select, battle settings, watch replay.
Okay.
That's how you watch the replay. You're welcome, Kevin.
Yo!
You're welcome.
I don't want
to. You're welcome. But if it makes you feel any better, it's
setup?
Not just
is
you.
Is that a Gutek setup?
Dude, you know, it's funny. I told that to a guy yesterday, and he was like, wait, but what are the settings that you need to change in the option? I'm like, there is no settings. It's there by default.
I'm talking about, like, when you're watching the replay.
Oh.
What do you look out for?
Oh, when you're watching the replay, you have to. Okay, what I recommend, this is what I tell all my students, is to watch the replay and write down at least one specific thing from each round that you notice. Specific action item type of stuff.
That's really.
Here's a bad example. I jump too much. Here's a good example.
Oh, here comes a huge comeback from M Lizard. And taking a mental note there. It was all.
Kevin Burnout Fighter says, peace out, M Lizard. I'm bringing the pain.
A good jump back there. Great anti-air from Burnout.
Oh my god, the chat is so triggered right now. I love how everybody is an Evo champion in the in the chat room. All of them. Like, you know, the Evo's been around for 20 years, but somehow we have 5,000 Evo champions in the chat room.
I have the pleasure to manage two Evo champions, so.
Well, I hope that next time you can manage to get one of them on the right flight.
I tried. Oh, and here comes the comeback again. Just when Burnout was doing so well. Oh, got lucky there.
I think Burnout is got a little mind fucked.
Yeah. Very, very unfortunate there.
He should offer to shake his hand again right now. Feel like, hey, what do you think?
I feel like Burnout will get triggered if M Lizard, after he wins.
Jesus, offers to shake his hand. Oh my god. That would be. That's definitely the new classic right there. If you thought that Ata letting Strider Ben beat him the first match, only to run it back from match point and loses the second match. M Lizard's got a new one for you.
I hope that doesn't happen because.
Don't take the handshake and then offer the handshake at the end. Oh, gosh. Oh. That was so good.
Shout out to the stream for still calling Evo champions Evo champions.
Yo, the chat never forgets and it never forgives.
And match point for M Lizard right now.
I still feel like Burnout. Whoa. I still feel like Burnout Fighter is just thinking about the handshake.
I feel that way too. That's the ultimate mind game. Nice teleporting. It seems like Burnout starts off well, and then just as the mid game starts, right?
Yeah.
Just dies.
Please, super. Okay. All right. Good.
But you see here, this is where M Lizard comes back again.
Well, Vega has a lot of comeback potential when he's got V Trigger and
okay, here it is.
Full super.
There's the comeback.
What? What? Okay, here it is. Here's the moment of truth. Oh my god, they just shook hands. God. That was the opportunity of the tournament.
Burnout should have just walked out.
As soon as it cuts back to, let's recreate how that should have went down.
Right.
I'm M Lizard. You're
This is not America here. This is Korea. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to the Capcom Pro Tour Manila Cup. Hey, you were talking about your students.
Yeah.
Do you offer a training program that I have not heard about before?
I do, but I don't really like to talk about it because it triggers so many people.
Why?
Instead,
it's a
you know why,
service.
Kevin? You know why, Kevin? Because people can't stand to see someone else
get better,
succeed.
The haters. Drinking the Haterade?
Oh my gosh, the Haterade.
Okay, I have
everything
I have done,
about what I do triggers you. Yes, you.
I have done Justin's lessons.
Yeah.
And I've done Sien's lessons. I have not done your lessons, but you have sat next to me in tournament and advising me.
Yeah, and what happened?
I can tell you.
Tell him what happened, Kevin.
I can tell you, it's the most amazing. Like, if you don't think coaching does not matter,
it friggin' matters.
And
let me tell you,
that
it matters.
Famous time where Sien says when Justin came up and wanted to give Sien advice, but Sien rejected it. He says, "Okay, I got this." Sien told me that he loves your advice.
That is the highest of compliments. Thank
yes.
you, Sien.
He usually doesn't get coaches, but he likes you coaching him.
Thank you. I try. I mean. Look, yeah, like, you can go to crosscountertraining.com. Do not go to my page. Instead, you should go to Sien or Justin or K-Brad or Ricky or Filipino Champ or Flash or Broly Legs or Alex Myers. Go to any of their pages because all of them are better trainers than I am.
I have to disagree.
But what I will say is that this is not a cheap, this is not an inexpensive service. But what would be more economical for somebody who was risk and price adverse is to go to crosscounter.tv and sign up for a free 1 month subscription, and you can access all of the recent training sessions that I've done with my students. There's like 6 or 7 of them up on the site live now. They're anywhere between, I would say, an hour and 10 and an hour and 35 minutes long. So if you don't want to spend
I have to disagree. I think the one-on-one sessions are invaluable.
Oh.
But here we go.
Well, these
we'll
are
talk
the
about that later.
These are the recorded training sessions with my students. Anyways, we'll talk about that later. All right, Eito versus Saito. Eito versus Saito.
Saito, a new face to the Capcom Pro Tour. Using Kami versus Hail Mary's Eito. Great entire. This is what
so triggered.
This is what Eita is famous for. His reactions are so godlike and clean. You can't jump in on him. He gets flustered and he gets nervous, but
Eita must be superhuman. We should test his DNA for mutant blood.
Oh, see, look at that.
Gosh.
At the last possible moment.
Amazing.
Him and Xiaohai, two best players to watch.
Woo! Here it comes. It's party time. Excellent.
Feet to the face. Big disgrace. Kicking Kami all over the place. Ken will rock you. Rock you like a hurricane. All right, 1-0. Very fast here. And this is what Eita brings.
All right. So, Saito's really got to be thinking about his trip from Japan here to the Philippines.
to get 1 point.
Wondering if it was
into the wilderness.
Wondering if it was all for nothing. Was it worth it?
I
go home and be a family man?
If he goes to the wilderness tonight, I think. He says no.
The fight is all.
The fight is all.
Win or lose, always a valuable experience to travel, especially to a beautiful country like the Philippines.
Yes.
Even if
you're beautiful people all around.
Oh my God, the people here are excruciatingly nice. And just for those of you guys that have never been to the Philippines, which I'm imagining is most of you, it's actually kind of strange to speak English here in Asia and have everybody speak English back to you like no problem.
It's because of the Americanization of a lot of Filipinos love the American culture.
Oh, dude, they are into it, man. I went to a restaurant that was it's like some sort of like barbecue joint with tacos, burgers, and ribs.
I was there. I was there last night.
Playing 90s alternative rock.
But Saito making a comeback here.
Final round.
Trying to stay alive in the loser's bracket.
But Eita's got full stick of butter right here. All he's got to do is hit one crouching medium kick into super to turn the tide. Oh my gosh. Is he going to... Okay. Eita on the... Almost being stunned right there. Wow. Caught him with the knuckle.
Bare knuckle.
Bare...
Dragon claw.
Oh no, caught Saito hitting a button right there. Activates V-trigger, He's still got full super. Oh my gosh, this is such a bad position for Saito. Didn't get his own uppercut out. They're both they're so V-triggered right now.
That's not juggle.
What a shimmy that was. Gosh, running circles around Eita.
No, it's not enough.
Eita cracked, Saito stays alive. Game of peace.
Fist bump with authority. Respect my authority! Respect it!
Round one.
Oh, Burnout Fighter running messages on his phone to the chat.
He's channeling the chat here.
Saito was feeling himself too much after the convincing performance of last round. That momentum has totally shifted to Eita. Closes it out with a near perfect.
This happened earlier the second game, so let's see if Saito is able to calm down and make the adjustments. Some players like to play from behind.
Yes. Yes, they do, Kevin.
No pun intended.
Oh, the puns are always intended, Kevin. You can lie to me and the people, Kevin, but you can't lie to yourself. All right, now Saito got his back to the wall right here. Is this the end? Is it going to be one Protoc point? I mean, one CBT point? Sorry. Protoc, Tuesday, 7 p.m., Mike Ross.
He hasn't been doing it for 3 weeks. What happened? Oh, and that's it for Saito. 1 point. Tonight there will be an after party. Hopefully he enjoys himself there. Do not head into the wilderness.
Oh yeah, somebody in the chat just posted out. Just reminded me that I forgot to mention that Flo was also available on the site. So basically, all of these guys.
Shout out to Flo. He's actually watching right now.
Oh, hi, Flo. Sorry, I dropped the ball, bro. I'm sorry. My tiny brain can only remember like three things at once.
He's such a kind soul, and he's so gentle, and he just broke his little heart.
I know. I'm sorry. I can only remember a few things at once.
All right. But, you know...
Kevin, put me on the spot. I don't have my laundry list of trainers.
I want to talk about how Philippines has changed people. You look at Spooky.
Dude.
Spooky
looks like a brand new person.
He actually, got younger.
Yeah.
He looks so tired and old in New York.
The Philippines contains, somewhere here in Manila, the fountain of youth.
The whole islands.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yep.
I definitely can see the appeal of being paid in U.S. dollars but living in a different country.
Well, let's not talk about that. I'm talking about just living here. Not about being financially stable or anything.
I think that alleviates some stress.
Some. But you look at all the Filipinos here. They are all young looking and healthy.
That's true.
You know, not everyone is making those USDs. They're still making the pesos.
The culture here is exceedingly friendly.
Yeah.
And I think
Spooky's hairline is getting better. There's more hair.
That's true.
His face acne has gone, cleared up. Now he's like silky smooth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true.
Round one.
Definitely his body is agreeing with the Filipino.
Dude. It's nice.
Yeah, it's really nice here. Alright, up now, Oil King with Rashid from Taiwan versus USA's very, very own EG Stone Cold Stunner, K-Bread!
K-Bread!
Mr. Hype Man himself, Mr. EG.
Oh my gosh, Oil King with the wake-up buttons. Is he going to activate the wind power? No, he doesn't. Throws out an EX spinning mixer that did not make contact. This could be it. Oil King on the verge of losing this first round of the set.
Oh.
That's it. K-Brad puts this one away, opens his eyes, yawns a little bit, says,
I got
okay.
this.
Okay.
Can you do the K-Brad impression? I feel like everyone in the FGC.
Mock Hammy. I'll think of something better that K-Rat would say.
Right.
Oh no! Didn't mean to run into that one. Watch my shimmy though.
That was so good. K-Brad. Dog.
Trying desperately to stay awake. Looking for a challenge from Oil King.
Resident Sleeper Burnout in full effect. He's actually watching, but it's just the angle of the shot makes him look sleepy.
That is the ultimate stream monstering right there. Going to an actual event to type words that scroll
across his chest. What can Oil King do to adapt and change?
That's a great question. And if I knew, I probably would have fared better against K-Brad, but I am the exact wrong person to ask.
I think this is a really terrible matchup too for Rashid. Because everything that Cammy does blows up Rashid's options. It's a really bad matchup. It's like 7-3.
Well, Oil King had a little bit of momentum right there. And then Cammy activates V-Reversal to escape the corner. I see what you're saying. Ooh, all right. It looks like he's got some good momentum right here. K-Brad on the verge of death right here, holding down back and then back for dear life. Reverses the momentum. Oil King now has to slow it down a little bit.
Oh,
ooh,
nice.
Runs
here.
Right into the handshake. Put her there, pal.
I like this Cammy costume here.
I like all of her costumes. Oh no, doesn't get the crush counter though. Might have been able to get more damage right there. But Oil King's got a good life lead. Trying to sit back, think about fossil fuels and how they relate to wind power.
You just use the money that you make from fossil fuel and invest it in wind power.
Dude, trust me, if I had any oil money at all, I would be putting it all into renewable. Just diversify. Wind, solar, hydro.
I think they're all doing that. Right?
You know, I've actually had some conversations with them, and it's worrisome that I don't think they all have.
I know Shell and BP are oil.
Oh, those guys.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm talking about the individuals that we know.
No, not those guys.
Here comes the wind power. Straight into it. Are we going to see some sort of mix? Oh, no. Misses the opportunity to convert off of the both hits of the tornado.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Here.
That was really hard to do. Oh, my gosh. K-Brad, I believe. Those mind games really did a number.
Rashid wins.
That was tough to recover from. But K-Brad going to take a breath. Is a little bit more awake now.
Round one.
I'm pretty sure playing Marvel Fight. Took a lot of gas out of his tank.
I believe in K-Brad, though. I think he's a fantastic player.
Oh, absolutely. But the thing about... the thing about playing multiple games, though, is that I believe that you only, you know, inside and out of, outside of fighting games, you only get one super meter per day of decision making and energy. If you use some of that meter on the equivalent of throwing out random EXs, aka playing other games, you're not gonna have as much left at the end when you need it.
But I feel like this a special gene in the EG boys, where they're able to play multiple games and win multiple tournaments.
We need to test the EG boys. We need to test all the players for mutant DNA. Calling it now. That's where me and Mike are running on. That's our platform for our election coming up. Yeah.
Hey, I want one of their shirts. Where do I buy it?
tpublic.com/crosscountertv.
Not Teespring, just TeePublic?
TeePublic.
All right.
But who knows? We might switch again. You know, commitment is hard.
Talk about commitment.
That's right. That's why I suck at this game.
Put a ring on it.
Oh, man. All right. Oil King doing a very good job of adjusting to Cammy and being able to react to Cammy's dive kicks.
Like K-Brad's gonna make a huge comeback.
K-Brad didn't want to spend the meter right there. It would have been too expensive.
Oh, great block there.
Oh my god, how did he block that mutant DNA? I'm positive of it.
Oh no, uppercut into the super.
Okay, match point.
Oh,
both players.
Uppercut into the critical art.
Oil King trying to get in K-Brad's head.
Fight.
Oh, punish here. Choose not to use the critical art early.
Yeah, you know, when he got that situation in the last round, it was debatable as to whether or not it was a good idea to use. Okay, there we go. Uses it on EX dive kick. Another one, both blocked by Oil King, who's going to create some space, back himself to the corner. Okay, nice tornado right there. Got a good lead. Had a good lead. Not anymore.
Both players full V trigger now.
Oh, they're so triggered right now, Kevin. They're triggered. I'm triggered. The chat is triggered.
No punish on that with Mixer.
Oh my gosh. K-Brad. Unlucky shimmy right there. EX. Oh. No! Didn't use the EX to go through the tornado. Looks like it wasn't necessary. Now, stuck in the corner. Pretty even on life here. Oh no! Gets hit by the minus A on block or V reversal. This could be it for K-Brad. Oil King has got full super.
He's going to do a random EX kick there, I think. Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, my
gosh. He had beam reversal. K-Brad had
there is some debate. There is some debate between Oil King, K-Brad asking for clarification in the chat room. Your homework, training mode monsters, recreate that situation. Mixer into super, and then see if you can get Cammy to B reversal. No, I know it's not a combo.
Yeah.
No, that's why I think that's what the debate was. See if you can.
Can you back that?
If you can block a couple hits of the mixer and then B reversal with Cammy, because I think that's what K-Brad. I'm not sure, but I think that's what K-Brad was saying.
If you guys find out the video, please.
I would love if somebody can clip. If somebody can clip that and then post that in the chat, and then one of you other stream monsters.
Hashtag Manila Cup 2016.
Yeah. Recreate the situation. So that, I mean, clip it and then post it in the chat so that other people can see it. And then maybe we can recreate the situation and then find out for sure.
Yep. Up next is Zowie Gaming's, Zowie's Gamer B from Taiwan versus Panda TV's Jiawa from China. These are two very good friends. Hanging out together, having a short chat. You know, when you were talking about commitment.
chat is so triggered. Yeah,
you're talking about commitment.
Yeah.
I get triggered because I listen to Chris Rock a lot.
Yeah.
And talking about commitment.
One of the best.
Versus new stuff.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. Was that the bigger and blacker special?
Yeah. Commitment will always be there for you. The new might not be able to cook. The new you, my name will cook or read, but you will definitely clear your mind.
Ha ha!
And right now, minds have to be cleared as we go into this next match. Top 16 loser side. This is how tough the tournament is.
One of these guys is going home. Who put Gamer B into loser's bracket?
Bonchan.
Bonchan put Gamer B into losers. Justin Wong put GY into losers.
Yep. Round one. Fight.
Very smart choice to play on the Ring of Destiny.
Yep. Xiao Xiang. Zawi Xiao Xiang versus Panda TV's Xiong Mao Dianshi the Jiewa. That's all the Chinese you're going to hear from me today.
That was about infinity percent more than y'all will hear from me
aren't
today.
Aren't you Asian?
No.
Straight up.
By blood, maybe.
All right. Good back throw there from Gamer B. Scream traps.
Caught him hitting buttons. Goes for the overhead. Unsuccessful. Gamer B going to back up. Let this little bit of this gray life recover.
Ooh,
just runs up the crush counter.
So much authority there. Oh, nice anti-air. Great dash forward throw.
Wow, two crouching medium. Wow, three crouching medium kicks in a row. Gamer B forgot how to block low.
Round two.
So I was recently schooled on how to commentate Nakali because his dash is actually called Disguidance.
Yes. But the Berserker Barrage.
Yeah. Winner stays on Logan Sama tells me slash, DP, and stomp.
Stomp. Yeah.
And
slash, DP.
And stomp. That's the right way to commentate Nakali. So slash.
Well, I mean, there is some debate as to, you know, what.
Using the proper names for moves?
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, like, I don't think that most of these moves were named with English commentators in mind.
Doesn't Capcom USA does the localization at the.
Sure, exactly. They do the localization.
Yeah,
which means that there
nice
was a different word in Japanese.
Yes.
Like, is the real Japanese word for the disc guidance. Is it actually disc's guidance? I have no idea.
I have no idea either.
But I'm sure one of the stream monsters knows. All right, so one round apiece. Jiwa's got a little bit of a life lead here. Gamer B is trying to doing that ground pound, trying to build up his V trigger. What makes Nakali one of the stronger characters is that once he's V-triggered and it's active, it lasts the rest of the round at the expense of his V-reversal.
Nice dash up there from Jiwa. Trying to keep the pressure on. Good footsie here.
Ooh.
A lot of jumping
by Jiwa. Oh no, runs into stomp into V-trigger super. This one's gonna hurt.
Cycle crusher into the chest. Oh wow, great way to end it. A charge there, slash charge, slashing charge from Gamer B. I'm just trying to get used to not saying this guidance.
Say, Kevin, do you, man.
Do me?
Do you. Say whatever you want.
I'm trying to switch it up. I want to get those pair of shoes that Ricky is wearing, though. Those are nice shoes.
Those are nice kicks.
Yeah. The Yeezys.
Are they really?
Yeah.
That was a terrible whistle. Nice kicks.
Sold out everywhere. Gotta go queue up. All right. It looks like
round one.
They were thinking about it, the both players, but now they're ready. Gamer B with the life lead, 1-0. And for you guys on stream,
big damage!
This is Gutek and Cameraman on commentary, top 8. We're gonna bring you the ESPN commentary. You and Mike Ross.
Oh no, I'm. I mean, I'll sit here for as long as people want. I mean, as long as King. You know, you guys may not know, Offcast, they call him King Louis out here.
King Louis?
Yeah, King Louis the Third. King Louis, Streamsmith, head Streamsmith here at Manila Cup
2016. All right, Gamer B on match point here on the verge of putting Doc Jiwa and Panda TV's Jiwa out of the tournament. EX Stomp, standing fierce with the cross counter. Good blocks on the overhead from Gamer B. Okay, Gamer B doing everything right here just to try to close out the round and the game. So nice and clean is Gamer B.
I think Jiwa's done. Oh my god, he caught him just sitting there.
Done.
Wow, what a finish. The audacity to block.
Gamer B. It's just a 50-50 game.
Oh, I know, but Gamer B was just like, I'm just going to wait, let him think about it, and then come here.
Free hugs.
All right, so we got PBE Don coming up next. One of the strongest players in the Philippines got sent to losers by Kazunoko, and he's going to be going up against the man who will not shake hands, M. Lizard.
Bars.
I want to see.
Hey, where's Mike Ross?
I have not seen Mike all day. I believe. I don't know. But I would love to see Don go for the handshake and have M. Lizard deny him again.
So
and now M. Lizard has another chance to deny Dan's handshake at the end with the no,
so
you don't.
Jimmy is the guy that's sitting with the pink man pouch.
the what?
The man pouch. The pink man pouch on the left.
Yeah, I see him. I see him. To the left
so
of M. Lizard.
So he's trying to hype out the crowd to say Don, but the crowd's like having none of it and calls out Jimmy instead. And that's what they talk. Like,
are they trolling him?
Yeah, they're trolling him. He's like, forget it. Sit down. And of course, PBE Playbook Esports Don. The best player currently in the Capcom Pro Tour Manila.
Wait, is this the Philippines' last hope?
Yeah, it is. Every single Filipino we saw lost. So
the last man standing. Everything rides on this, Don. No pressure.
Let me tell you, the Filipinos are not going to leave even if it's Don.
They're not going to what?
Leave.
Leave.
Yeah. There's some communities when their countrymen is done, they leave.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, most countries.
Yeah, these guys are going to stay.
Till the bitter end?
This is not a bitter end. This is the hypest tournament of...
Well, I mean...
In, like, months.
That's...
Weeks. Days. They're not going to leave. You have Justin Wong. You have Kazunoko. You have Mike Ross. Who's going to leave here?
Not me. I'm here.
This Gutex?
I'm here. Don't worry. This. Okay. Now, this is a very... I'm anxious to see what Don does differently in this match so that I can learn what I should have been doing against M. Lizard.
More DPs.
Woo!
Very careful play right now.
Yeah, slow start here. No rush. We got all day.
And if you see, compare the difference between Don's Ryu versus Daigo's Ryu, definitely a lack of spacing and knowledge of the normals that he should be throwing out against M. Lizard is blatantly clear. You can see this matchup here.
Ouch, that is his uppercut. When he's triggered, man, his uppercut hurts. All right, M. Lizard. Oh no, missed the opportunity right there. M. Lizard got full super to work with, but no nice. B-trigger. But he's probably going to get another one.
And Lizard disrespecting Don by jumping in twice.
Three times.
In very critical range. Hey, M. Lizard gave that one away, man. Why did he jump in three times at, like, weird distances?
Mind games.
Side by side, baited.
Yeah.
Fake buttons galore. He did the Baye.
Ah, yes. The classic. Got eight buttons, only need six. I got two fake ones. Alright, M Lizard. Got PBE Don's back to the wall right here. Right by the butler, not where you want to be.
Oh, nice jump out there.
Ooh, looked like he was going for a shimmy right there. Didn't quite. Oh, no! Too far for
huge
that uppercut.
There.
Yeah. Nice damage there by M Lizard. This is the most frustrating position to be in against Vega.
Oh, there
you
it
just
is.
Take
this
a
is
sweet time.
Oh, that's not used to critical art for some reason.
Well, I mean, the thing is, I think he knows that he has a very low chance of winning that round. Therefore, it would be better to start the third round with full super.
Final round. Fight.
Actually, I think he would have a high chance there. Because after the super.
Ah, see, there we go. That's why he saved it.
But he would have gotten a knockdown and a stun gauge. So one more combo, he would have actually sealed that round.
Well, he's got a really strong, really big life lead right here. But M Lizard has a lot of comeback factor potential right here because he has full V trigger and full critical art.
Oh,
no!
No!
Not anymore! He doesn't!
That's a huge drop.
Threw the rose away as well as his chance of winning this round.
Now Don can throw fireballs as much as he wants. Wow, nice overhit there from
M Lizard standing up. Oh no, not quite enough.
Jimmy, Jimmy's like, you guys are someone needs to translate what they say. Mabuhay?
I'm not quite sure what it means.
Mumbaye.
But I think it means, let's go Don, Manila is behind you.
Oh, two throws, no third. Nice fireball.
Don's working on a good lead right here. I think M Lizard has gotten the message, or maybe he didn't quite get the message not to jump. He's trying to play a more ground-centric game here, which allows Don to throw more fireballs.
This is a huge fireball there.
And the claw is knocked off. Not looking good for M Lizard here.
Oh, and this is dire straits here for M Lizard.
Yeah. I mean, without
the claw
V-trigger. Yeah, without V-trigger and full super, Vega's chances of a comeback are very small.
Oh, but here he goes.
One hit'll do it. One pixel, no life. M Lizard staying alive though. Gotta give credit.
Oh, what? Nice block. Great pushes for M Lizard.
Oh my gosh.
Not good. Oh.
Okay. It's close.
Hey, Dr. Jimmy with that big man pouch. Getting hype for his boy. Nice air throw there from M Lizard. Don is playing so well right now.
Yeah, but M Lizard's been slowly picking away at Don's health. I mean, he's gotten like 30% of his life gone just on seemingly one button alone. Don's gonna need to be a little bit more careful here. Activates V-trigger. Not exactly a game changer in this instance. Yeah. Wow. M Lizard did a really good job of
wasting that V.
Yeah, not letting him really get anything out of it.
Oh, great footsies and a shimmy.
Manila going nuts right now. M Lizard.
I have to disagree with M Lizard using that. Oh, dropped it!
Missed the opportunity to combo into the Tatsu. I think Don was thrown off by the crowd getting hyped.
Yeah.
Both of these guys playing with no headphones. Not advisable in my opinion. So now Don looked like he had that one locked up.
Yeah.
And it looks like he may have lost some of his momentum. M Lizard slowly pushing him to the corner.
And I think M Lizard found a special button here, which is the down medium punch.
Yeah.
That Don has had a lot of trouble dealing with so far. Oh, big punish here.
There we go. The crowd's starting to get hype again. M Lizard still going forward with the game plan.
I have to disagree with that.
I don't know why he did that.
V trigger. Oh, here comes the uppercut. One more.
You guys can hear Manila getting hype. Oh, and that's it. Wow. It worked. Jimmy, best cheerleader, PBE Don, stays alive. The pride of the Philippines.
This is why
gets
I
another
like
chance. Dude, the Philippines is hype, man.
This is why I love hometown support. Home
yes.
court advantage.
Yes, home court advantage cannot be understated. And it looks like we're going to have another Japan versus Japan match.
Action. Red Bull's Bonchan versus Hail Mary's Eita.
Eita, if you guys were watching yesterday, got put into loser's bracket by one of the Filipino players, Strider Ben. That was a great match.
Yeah, if you want to see the recap of those two matches, either go to Capcom Fighters on Twitter. We have clips there, as well as Facebook. And Facebook as well. Or you can subscribe to twitch.tv/CapcomFighters and can access all the archives there.
Yeah, sounds like a plan.
Our Lord
beat you to it. I'm already subscribed, Kevin. King, but thank you for the reminder.
I'm telling the stream.
Yeah. Support the channels that you
love.
That you guys love.
And of course, King Louis has just informed us that this is our last match before top 8.
Yeah, so we are coming down to the wire.
There's a Filipino player in top 8.
Wow.
And, wait. Tapusin. Finish him. Oh, to all visitors.
Ah, Tapusin means finish him. Wow.
Bloody
thank you,
Vince.
Bloody Vince.
Talia.
Tala Manila Cup. Oh, I think that was the girl that was wearing the Bullet Club shirt yesterday.
Hey, she's right there. She's right there.
Where?
She's being shy. Right there on the top left.
Okay.
Okay, so where, last game of top 8, we're going to take a short break. We'll be back. Be sure not to go anywhere. If not, hit the follow button or the subscribe button. Thank you guys so much for your support. Up now, it's Red Bull's Bonchan with Nash versus Hail Mary's Eita with Ken. Top 8, last match, top 16 before top 8.
One of these guys is going to be a salty ride home.
Yep.
Everyone needs
Japan.
Points right now. Both players on still lack of a lot of points to qualify for the Capcom Pro Tour.
Which is crazy because Eita just coming off a big top 8 finish at Evo this year.
Not as big. Not big enough. But Eita has already qualified for the Capcom Pro Tour Asia final. So.
Oh, okay. Well, that's...
Wow.
And we can see why here. Starting off this match against Bonchan with a perfect.
So technically, Bonchan has way more to lose right now than Eita.
Interesting.
Alright, a much better round from Bonchan right now. Good sweeps.
Bonchan trying to play as safe and careful as possible here. But in the corner, not where you want to be against Ken. But he does have V-Trigger and, well, it's not going to matter.
Could have guard.
He could have used V-Reversal. He could have done V-Trigger. Instead, looks like he's going to have to regroup.
Look, Bonchan's not phased. Look, he's like, pulls his wire back, tries to relax.
Oh, man. That look on his face did not inspire confidence, though.
Bonchan.
Round one.
This is actually one of my favorite stages of Street Fighter V.
Oh, yeah.
The soundtrack is crazy.
Misplay Sonic Boom right there. Eita gets a big opening now. Stuck again. Same situation as last time. Not gonna use any. Okay. Alright, there we go. Finally. I mean, look, you get anywhere between, let's say, 4 and 6 V-gauge stocks per round. If you don't use them, it's just missed opportunities.
I agree. Oh, he
didn't get the counter hit, yeah.
But here you go. Huge combo here.
Nice conversion. That's
wanted to
what
make
I'm
sure
talking
that
about.
He kills. He uses all the critical arts. don't know if it will kill if he uses the EX Scythe.
It was definitely worth it to spend the bar in that instance. Take no chances. This is loser's bracket, Kevin. One of these guys is going home.
You flew all the way out here, a 2-hour flight.
Is it only 2 hours?
2 to 3.
Just thinking about my flight on Wednesday.
Oh, nice. Uppercut kick there.
All right, so Bonchan looking very strong right here. Looks like he's completely recovered. But again, stuck in the corner against Atoff. Back by the fruit stand.
Is that a Mario in the back? Yellow hand Mario.
Ooh, quick second game by Bonchan. Takes a sip of that Red Bull. The wings have been given. Nash
wins. Wait, there's cops in here.
It wasn't me. Definitely was not me.
Round one. Cops have blue uniform, white. As security guards, they're just here to check out the action. All right, good. This has been back and forth for both players right now. It looks really good for Bonchan so far. A more controlled game is what Bonchan is looking for. While you're looking for a street fight and a messy fight, that's Ada's game plan.
Yeah.
Tries to whip punish, but Ada just uppercuts.
Oh no, so that run is so hard to react to. Bonchan stuck in the corner. Oh, nice! Wow, just low profiles underneath.
Great game knowledge there from Bonchan. Confidently squat there.
But back in the corner, got V-trigger and V-reversal. Gosh! Oh, he tried to V-trigger, but it got stuffed. Okay, this is match point for Ata.
He only got a V-trigger after he died.
Oh. No, but he used it.
He used it a few times already. He was gone. He didn't use the last time.
All right, we gotta check the tapes on that one. Bonchan, remember guys, this is, it's only 2 out of 3. Top 8 is gonna be 3 out of 5. Yeah. Bonchan's got his back to the wall. V-trigger and full super, what can he do? If anything, can't do nothing.
Ada ends it with the perfect here.
Oh my gosh, one game away from top 8. That is a heartbreaker.
Bonchan's.
Oh man, I feel the pain on that one, Bonchan. I do, man.
All right, thank you guys so much. We want to give a shout out to our sponsors, XSplit, for providing the venue and the stream and all the camera crew. Of course, player.me, if you guys want to go check out their new social media site, as well as challenge.com, their bracket management site. They're gonna do some big combination of everything together. It's gonna be super awesome. Check it out.
That's what I hear.
Yep.
Also, shout out to the rest of the sponsors, including Sony PlayStation, of course,
yep.
Capcom,
presented
Imperium,
by
Globe, ViewSonic, Predator, all the heavy hitters, all the sponsors that help make Manila Cup that much better and bring it from the Philippines to your eyeballs.
They were surprised that, like, the Red Bull lady was like, I didn't know this was such a big event. Like, Justin Wong is here. Mike Ross is here.
Oh, like she? What? Oh, she didn't know it was.
She thought it was gonna be like a casual, like a weekly. And it's like, I didn't know it was gonna be that many.
That's good. I mean, and when you're selling sponsorship decks, right? You want to under-promise and over-deliver.
Yeah.
Whoever sold Red Bull on this package was like, yeah, there's gonna be like 5, maybe like 10 people there.
Yeah.
And Robo's like, all right, we'll send the girls. We'll bring more Red Bull than you guys can drink. Oh man, there's a hell of people here.
Why is
what
Mike Ross and Gutex here? Why is our sponsored Red Bull athlete, Bonchan, here? And he's like, oh, okay. I guess
this was a good decision.
Yes.
Bring all right, guys. Well, sit back. We're gonna take a quick break. So this would be a good opportunity for you guys to use the facilities, get yourself a beverage, order some food, make something really quick, put something in the microwave, because we're going to come back with top 8 of Manila Cup here at the tail end of the Capcom Pro Tour 2016. It's been awesome. Thanks for watching, guys. Sit tight. We'll be right back.
See you guys later.